Hey everybody, I'm Gardner, the Linux Gamer, and welcome to Linux Literate. It's a new video series I want to try out. I get asked all the time about Linux-specific issues. New users who are familiar with the Windows way of fighting against your computer, they have a ton of questions. How to use the terminal, how to compile software, how to install proprietary graphics drivers, and just where the hell does software actually get installed to? I want to help people when they ask me how to do such things, so instead of responding to private messages and only helping one person, I figured I can make a video about it and help a bunch of people with the same issue. Now, keep in mind two things. There's more than one way to do everything this series is going to tackle, and this is by no means comprehensive, or even the easiest way of doing whatever I'm talking about. And second, I'm really not the best person to ask about really advanced stuff. With all that being said, let's talk about the Linux file system. If you're coming from Windows, and many of you are, the Linux file system might seem a bit foreign. I can hear you asking, where are all my games installed to? That's a great question, and to answer that, I'll help you get familiar with your home directory. As a new Linux user, it's best practice to not write to or modify any system components. Typically, your user account won't have permission to do such a thing anyway. Thankfully, just about everything you need as a new user is available to you within your home directory. So let's open it up and take a look at what's inside. Okay, everything so far seems pretty self-explanatory, but what happens when we show hidden files? Ah, there we go. Now, you might notice a bunch of files and directories with a period prefixing the name. This naming convention hides things from normally being displayed in the terminal or within your file manager. So what are all these hidden files? Well, these are generally user-specific configuration files, and often there's also applications installed here. Depending on what you have installed on your computer, it might look quite a bit different from what I've got here on mine. Now let's explore a few of these directories. First we have .config, which, as you might have guessed, is user-specific configuration files for things like GNOME, Discord, Chrome, Kdenlive, and more. Next on the list we have .local. Within this folder is another directory, share. Any files you have written here will supersede files found at the system level. You can also install user-specific fonts, icon packs, and more. Now you might be wondering, where is C program files? There's no one place that's analogous in the Linux world. Most of the apps you install from a package manager are going to be all over the file system. However, there are a few exceptions. Applications like Steam and most games downloaded from GOG will get installed to your home directory. Steam can be generally found in home/.steam and the games installed in home/.steam/steam/steamapps/common. I didn't come up with that. Games from GOG typically get installed in home/GOG games. Now I can hear you saying, how do I install games on my secondary drive? Well, Linux doesn't have the concept of letter drives, so there really isn't a C drive or a D drive on Linux. Instead, Linux mounts drives as part of a virtual file system. I'll cover this topic on the next episode of Linux Literate. But what do you think? Do you have any questions about Linux you'd like to see answered? Leave me a comment and let me know, or tweet at me at the Linux Gamer. If you enjoyed this video or found it useful, make sure you share it with your friends and subscribe to see more from me, the Linux Gamer. Thanks for watching.